If I can only choose 10 fragrances for life, what would they be? If you want to see more, please continue to watch. Hello, beautiful people, and welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time watching, I'm Cheraye. Welcome. If you happen to be returning, you are truly appreciated. Thank you so much, and welcome back. Today, I'll be sharing with you, I'm sure you can tell by the title, my 10 for life. You guys, this was so hard to decide. It was so hard to choose. I was going to do 10 niche, 10 designer, or I was thinking about doing 5 niche, 5 designer, but I just said, girl, if you had to choose 10 right now, December 2020, for life, what would you choose? If you want to see what I chose, please continue to watch. Here on this channel, I do cover fashion, beauty, luxury, and lifestyle. So if you like any of those things, or perhaps you're like me and you too like all things fabulous, go ahead and consider hitting the subscribe button. Don't forget to hit the bell because I would hate for you to miss a video over here. And without further ado, let's get started. You guys, oh my gosh, it was so hard to decide. Okay, I'm coming in no particular order. I just really took my time and I went through my collection and I was looking. At first I had 20 and I was like, girl, it's 10. Just pick 10. And these are the 10 that I chose. Now I'm gonna say this. If you come back next week, next month, in the next 4 hours, this could all change. But at this moment, right now, coming in number one is Perfumes de Mali Delina. Absolutely love this. It is a classic. It is a staple in my collection. I waited forever to get this, and I actually didn't even get it. My guy got it for me for Valentine's Day. He's like, girl, I'm sick of you. You need to have this. Put it in your life. So forever, I will always want this in my collection. It is a beautiful fragrance, you guys. I took some notes. I'm not going to go deep into it, but in case it's your first time watching or ever hearing about this fragrance, I want you to know a little bit about it. It is a beautiful, upbeat, effervescent. It could be worn year round. To me, I really love it in the spring and the summer. They have an exclusive version that's a little harder, deeper, sexier, sensual, that I think is really nice for the fall and the winter. It has bergamot, rhubarb, leche, nutmeg. I can't even talk. Peony. It has cashmere, vetiver. It is a beautiful fragrance, and this will forever be, as of right now, in my top 10. I move on. Another one, Tom Ford Black Orchid. This will always be in my top 10. This is just everything. I love this fragrance. It's very beautiful. It's very polarizing. I do not recommend blind buying this. I always recommend start with the sample. It's a love at first sniff for me. It's chocolate. It's luxurious. It's sexy. It's sensual. Cacao, jasmine, dark chocolate. It's a warm, spicy, sexy, get your finest on. Let's go out to dinner. Let's go out to a steakhouse. Let's get our entire lives. I've missed you. Where have you been? Welcome home. Oh my gosh. Girl, you didn't even smell it. You guys, I love this fragrance, okay? I have so many memories with this fragrance. I already tell you. You already know. This right here can get it. It is good, good. I move on. Sticking with Tom Ford, my summertime fragrance, my summertime vibe, that is none other than Tom Ford Soleil Blanc. This is the EDP. This is amazing. This is coconut. I always tell you, every time I even think about this fragrance, smell it, get a whiff of it, from the moment that I first tried it, it just made me feel so like, you know, get on a yacht and like take me out, set sail, set sea, pop a bottle, do something. You know what I mean? Go sit, have dinner looking at the ocean, watch the sunrise the next morning. It is very, very luxurious. I find it to be sexy. I find it to be tropical. You can wear this on, you can wear this anywhere you want. This is where she's wearing it. You can wear this on vacation. It's a perfect vacation scent. It makes me happy. Some have said it smelled like Bronze Goddess, you guys, and I have gotten a chance to smell Bronze Goddess, and I still find this to be just a little bit more luxe, in my opinion. Let me give you some of the notes. Like I said, it has coconut. It's a white floral, jasmine, tuberose, pink pepper, bitter almond. This right here is another one that is good, good. Just know everything on this list is good, good. It wouldn't even be in my top 10 if it wasn't. Hello, I move on. Oh gosh, of course she was gonna be in here. Did you not? How could you not? Why would you not? I gotta stop listening to Big Sean. Like, why would you not? Okay, anyways, you guys, right here, Coco Noir. This right here is definitely a top 10. I love this fragrance. Out of all Chanel's fragrances, that's too hard. I can't make that call. I can't make it. But this is like absolutely up there as one of my absolute favorites. I really, really love this fragrance. It's super, super sexy to me. I wear this date night. I wear this date day. But mostly, I put it in the date night category. This is just something that I will forever have in my collection. The body lotion, the shower gel, the whole entire thing. Chanel, in case it's your first time to the channel, is my my absolute favorite fragrance house ever, hands down. I love, love, love their fragrances, as well as their bags, their shoes, their ready to wear, their fashion jewelry. Okay, you name it. If Chanel has it, she loves it. Let me give you some of the notes in here, you guys. This one here is just patchouli. It's tonka bean. It's warm. It's sexy. It gets the job done. It makes me feel like a boss. It makes me feel classy, elegant, refined, all of the above. Need I say more? This is Chanel, darling. I move on. Fix your hair, girl. I've been talking about this one like crazy, you guys. Yes, it is Flower Bomb. This is always gonna be in my collection. I have been reaching for this like crazy. I cannot get enough of it. I love it, especially during this time of year where it's cold and it's crisp out. And then this is just like a flower explosion waiting to happen. It's got the bergamot. It's a white floral. It's intoxicating. It's more of a gourmand, in my opinion. You've got jasmine, orange blossom, patchouli, rose. It is a beautiful, beautiful fragrance. Do not let the patchouli fool you. It is not a heavy, heavy, you know, patchouli type fragrance, although she loves patchouli. You get more of the rose, more of the floral bouquet more than anything. It's just very sexy. Like I said, this will be great for a signature scent. This could have been my signature scent if I wore a signature scent, but since I don't, I'll just keep it in my top 10. It's good. I mean, I don't know if you've never heard of Flower Bomb, if you've not had a chance to get a whiff of it, but she, her, highly recommends it. You guys, I tell you the truth, this right here is good, good. I move on. Oh my gosh, another one. This was so hard because I didn't know if I wanted to go with the original, or I didn't know if I wanted to go with the extreme version. But then I said, which one have you been reaching for? I wanted to go with one of it for the sentimental reason. This is the one that I found first and I stumbled upon. But then I said, but I don't reach for that one all the time. And if you only had to put one in your collection for life, which one would it be? It would be this one here, based on Francis Kirk John. This is the famous Baccarat Rouge 540, but not just the original, darling. This is the extreme version. You guys, it's softer, it's sexier. The almond note in there for me just hits different. In my opinion, I want both in my collection, but since we're just doing the top 10, this is the one that I would choose to take with me for life. I just really, really like it. It's very sexy, it's smooth. This, a man, a woman, a boy, a child, you already know a human can rock any of these fragrances, but this smells really, really good. A guy. My guy wore this the other day and I was like, oh, hello? Excuse you? Let me give you some of the notes. Saffron, bitter almond, cedarwood, you guys, as I said, ambergris. This right here is, wait for it, it's good, good. I move on. Of course, Chanel Beige was gonna be in here. Absolutely, this is hands down a favorite, my absolute favorite. This is from the Les Exclusive line. This is just a very upbeat, happy, rich, luxe, everything that Chanel embodies. Sophisticated, classy, elegant. But for some reason, this fragrance, when I think about it, it just really makes me happy. This is one of the fragrances that I reached for a lot when we first found out about 2020 and all that it entitled and entailed, what have you. I reached for this a lot. I would just come in my closet those days and I was like, we're what? Don't go out of the house. Why? You know what I mean? When we were all finding out about it in late March. And then when it got into like April, I would just come in my closet and I would just pick this up. Oh my gosh. Oh, and it just makes me happy. I have so many amazing memories with this fragrance. And that's one thing that I really, really love and can appreciate about fragrance. Just like I, you know, love and appreciate about music. It just transports you and it takes you back to a time and place. And I didn't really want to spray it because I didn't want to associate it with 2020. But I would just sniff it. And some days, you know, in the month of August, of course, my birthday month, I did wear it. It just has happy memories, fun times, good vibes, good energy. And for that, I will always be appreciative to this fragrance. Oh my God, am I getting sentimental? You guys, okay? Girl, can you not? Anyways, yeah, Chanel Beige got me through 2020 and I absolutely love it, or is getting me through. We're at the end of it now, thank God. If you're here in the 12th month of 2020, hello? Hit the like button. If you're just like, what is she talking about? Hit the subscribe button. It doesn't matter, you guys. Whatever you do over here, we just hit buttons. Okay, I move on. Another one is this beauty right here. You guys, how gorgeous is this bottle? Oh my gosh, it's absolutely gorgeous. This is Passion de l'Amour from the House of Sillage, and this is the limited edition bottle. It is absolutely stunning. It is gorgeous. And of course, I love this. I told you I rocked this for my birthday. This is definitely going to be in my top 10 for life. I just find the oud and the rose and the sexiness and the beast and the projection of this fragrance just to be truly unique in my opinion. And I really, really love it. I am so happy when I, you know, played with the discovery kit and I came upon this one and I was just like, oh my gosh, like I have to have this in my life. Oh my God, and I have tied such an amazing memory with it. Yes, even through 2020, I have tied an amazing memory with this. A few of the notes in here, you guys, is saffron, raspberry, it has caramel, it has oud, like I said, latex, absolute. It's just a beautiful, beautiful fragrance. I know I've spoken with so many of you about this fragrance, and we all share the same love for Passion de l'Amour. You guys, I did get a new cupcake though. I'm gonna be sharing it with you. Make sure you come back. You don't wanna miss it. I move on. Okay, so we have two more. This was a recent discovery. I would say I probably got this year, fell in love with it at the top of the year, and it was not a love at first sniff. It was not a love. It was a what in the world? I don't know what the hype is all about. Then I began to play with it a little bit more, and I began to wear it out, and I was like, oh my gosh, okay, I get it. She's gonna need a full bottle in her collection, and that is, yes, Creed Aventus for her. I absolutely love it. This really, look at this. Look at the dent that I've put in this already. This really got me through a lot of the summer months in 2020. You know what I say, spray what you want, when you want, and spray as much of it as you want. I've worn this in the, you know, cooler season, and it's okay, but it's really beautiful in the spring and the summer, and I really, really love this fragrance. I don't know what it was when I first picked it up and had a little sample from Royalty Scents. I was just like, I don't get it. Like, what's the hype? What's the big deal? But then as I wore it out and I began to play with it, I was like, oh, okay. And then, you know, even we were staying inside, so I would even just wear it downstairs or wear it for the day as my scent of the day, and I was just like, I really like this. And I was like, that's it, I need a full bottle. Let me give you some of the notes. It has a little bit of everything in it, so I'm just gonna give a few just so you get the gist of where I'm going. It has bergamot, patchouli, sandalwood, it has green apple, it has pink pepper. It's probably what it is. I love a pepper in a fragrance. It's very nice, you guys. It's but you might be like me, so I would say start with the sample. And then it kind of, what I really think now that I have remove the cap and I'm smelling it. I have a story time on my channel talking about Creed Aventus, you know, for guys, and how I stumbled upon it, and you know, I got that for my guy for our birthday, anniversary, something, you guys, I can't recall. And every time I smell this, I smell a little bit of him, but then I smell a little bit of me because I wear this. So I don't know. You know, everything for me has meaning, it's sentimental, that's just who she is. But Creed Aventus for her is definitely in my top 10. I move on. And our final one. This one is sweet. It's creamy. I love the way that it makes me feel, especially right now. I've been playing with it. Hair, what are you doing? I've been playing with it a lot. Ever since I got it, you know, ever since I had this little tiny sample, depending on how long you've been watching the channel. I started with just a little sample. I was in the Bloomingdale's and I stumbled over to this particular counter, and I just asked the lady, you know, what are some of the popular scents, and, you know, can I just, you know, get a whiff of them all? And she said, sure. And then I came on this one, and I was just like, oh my gosh, I was taken aback a little bit. I was like, OMG, I want this. And I it was my first time really smelling it or really having an encounter with it, so I wasn't really sure. It was pretty, it was a pretty penny, so I didn't really want to spend on it. So I asked her, can I have a sample? And she said, oh, we don't have any samples. And I was like, oh my gosh, I really would like to play with this and see how I like it before I buy it. And she goes, you know what, I'll go ahead and make you one. And she just made one. It wasn't even in a real sample container, you guys. It was like a container for, like, I don't know, foundation or something. But she made me a sample, and I played with it. I got home and I was like, oh my gosh, that's it, I need it. And when it went on sale, yep, I got it. And that is this beautiful, rich, vibrant color juice here, which is Angelique Noir. It is a beautiful fragrance, you guys. It is so sexy, so elegant, so classy, so rich, so refined, so, you know, subtle and laid back, but in the most luxurious, refined, classy, elegant way. Even, do you get a boss a little bit? A little bit of a boss, a little sexy. It smells along the line of, and it doesn't, but just let me state this just in case you've never smelled it. If you've ever smelled Benevolence from House of Sillage, it gives me that kind of a vibe. If you've ever smelled Killian, Love Don't Be Shy, it gives me that kind of vibe, but they're not the same. Please don't mistake them for the same. But I mean, it's in that realm. It's in that zhuzh of a fragrance. This right here is just done so well and blended so well that I just absolutely love it. So this is by Guerlain. This is Angelique Noir. And this is in my top 10 for life. I move on. I would love to hear what fragrances are at the top of your list for life for only 10. Please leave some of them in the comment section below. I would love to hear from you. If this was your first time to the channel and you enjoyed the vibe, please consider hitting the subscribe button. If you don't want to miss any videos over here, go ahead and smash the bell. That is it for today's video. Thanks so much for taking the time to stop by my channel. I truly appreciate you. Be safe, be well. Until next time, you know the drill. Be blessed, stay fit, stay fabulous, but more importantly, wear your mask and stay safe. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.